Φίλες και φίλοι, καλησπέρα. Έχουμε μαζί μας τον Κώστα Κουφό. Κώστα, welcome in Athens. Let's start from your decision to come to play in overseas after a big career in the NBA. It was a tough decision to come to play in Moscow.
No, look, for me, you know, it's basketball is basketball. Basketball is universal. But, you know, for my situation, you know, it was a part of a winning organization with CSKA. You know, I looked at the roster, there's a lot of good players on the team. I felt like it helped my development, my growth as a basketball player. And that was one of the reasons why I decided to go to CSKA.
What did you expect to find in Moscow, and what did you find?
You know, their traditions, you know, they're orthodox. You know, they're on the old calendar. You know, I already know a lot about Moscow before, you know, from doing research and stuff like that. But, you know, everybody, I've had a pleasant experience so far. You know, my Rush teammates are wonderful, just like the rest of my other teammates. And, you know, it's a learning experience still, but, you know, it's an opportunity, and it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for me.
Basketball-wise, do you think that the fact that you started your EuroLeague journey in a team with a great basketball tradition, with eight European trophies, made it easier concerning your tradition? Also, there are three Greeks that can help you also.
Yeah, I mean, it's a huge plus. You know, just not the European championships, but, you know, the staff and, you know, the players that are involved with it, you know, it's definitely it provides an atmosphere for success.
So far from what you've seen, is it fair to say that CSKA has nothing to be jealous from an NBA organization?
Look, you know, we're a very talented team. Like I said before, you know, basketball is universal. But, you know, who knows on any given day, you know, what could happen. Look, you know, NBA and the EuroLeague are two, you know, different types of leagues. You know, they have different styles of play, but there are a lot of very talented guys that are in EuroLeague that can play in the NBA.
You missed a significant time because of an injury in the preparation, and also the first month and a half, and that cost you your role in the rotation. How do you feel about the fact that you're not playing match time?
Look, you know, it's what it is. You know, it happens. You know, you learn from it and you grow. It's all about being a professional. You know, I'm still, you know, working out. I'm in great shape. You know, I've done a lot of great things in my whole career. And I know what I can do and what I can produce on the court, and I've shown that before. Whenever my number is called, you know, whether it's 2 minutes or 7 minutes or whatever it is, I'm going to play them hard. And the most important thing right now is having the winning mentality and keep winning games.
This is your first visit in Athens after something like 5 years. You guys lost to the two Greek teams in the first round in Russia. How do you see the game tomorrow in a gym that I assume that you never visited before?
You know, I've been in the gym, but
you didn't play.
First time playing, for sure.
Yeah.
You know, Spanoulis is playing great. You know, he's a legend, obviously. And, you know, I don't know if Paredes will be healthy tomorrow, but, you know, I know those guys are familiar with those guys. You know, same with Costa, Papanikolaou. And they got a lot of talented guys on their team. And, you know, Kornanis as well. And we can't take them lightly. You know, they beat us at our place. But, you know, tomorrow we just have to play CSKA basketball, play hard defensively, and continue to execute our plays.
If you had to talk to an American friend in the summer during your vacations about your experience with Vasilis Panoulis as a teammate or as an opponent, what would you tell to this guy about a basketball player who is 30, almost 38 years old, and he's scoring 30 points?
He's got my utmost respect for him. I've always had respect for him growing up, and he's got the Kobe Bryant mentality. You know, he's, you know, always, you know, in attack mode, which is great. And, you know, he's very driven, and that's definitely other people can feed off of that around him.
You played 4 years in Sacramento. How would you explain the hell happened about the fact that these two European guys, which ran the organization basketball-wise, Vlade and Peja, didn't pick Luka Doncic in number two of last year's draft, and they picked
Marvin Bagley
the third.
Yeah, but look, you know, Peja and Vlade are wonderful people, and they're, and I, in my opinion, are great GMs. You know, Luka's having a hell of a season, and it shows. You know, he's having a tremendous year. He's an all-star this year, and he's well-deserved. You know, I've seen Marvin Bagley, and he's very talented, and, you know, the sky's his limit. you know, reminds me of a Chris Bosh 2.0, which is crazy. And you know, I think, you know, some players take a little bit of time, but you know, I think with Marvin Bagley, you know, it's going to show in the future, in the near future.
Also in Sacramento, you played 1 year and a half with George Papagiannis. You played against him in EuroLeague. You saw he's improving. Do you think that he's in a good spot about growing in basketball?
I think so. You know, Rick Pitino's done a hell of a job with the team. Papagiannis is a hard worker. He's got great hands. He's tall. He can jump. You know, he's got a lot of intangibles. And you know, before the game, you know, just watching him a little bit in the warm-ups and stuff, you know, you could tell, you know, he's improved, and I'm happy for him and his family.
Speaking about Rick Pitino, as you mentioned, let's go to the national team chapter. It's been 5 years since we saw you with the jersey of the national team from the Eurobasket 2015. Last summer, it looked pretty sure that you would play in the World Cup. But what happened?
Me too. Look, you know, I told him I wanted to play. And whatever happened behind the scenes, I don't know about. It was unfortunate, but you know, I was open to playing the summertime, and just what it is. You know, it was unfortunate to see on Twitter that I wasn't on the roster, and it is what it is. You know, you as a player, you know, you kind of wanted to play and show up for your country, but you know, things happen, and you just got to keep pushing forward and continue to grow as a player.
There were some rumors that that some players didn't want you in the team. Can you confirm that?
Nah, this is just rumors. I mean, whoever says that, I mean, it is what it is. You know, look, I respect everybody around me, and, you know, I help others around me, and there's people that say that, and they're entitled to their own opinions.
Yeah, you will be available for this summer, under Rick Pitino in the pre-Olympic in Canada.
Right now I can't confirm something. You know, I got to be healthy. You know, still a lot of season left. My main priority, my main focus is with Cheska, and obviously we want to win a championship this year.
Did you think about a nightmare and or faced hard time to believe the passing of Kobe when you heard the bad news?
It was definitely tragic, especially, you know, having his 13-year-old daughter with him and also the other people that were in the helicopter. You know, you never want that to happen to nobody. It's very unfortunate. You know, my thoughts and prayers go out to the Bryant family as well as everybody else that passed away in the helicopter.
After playing more than a decade in the NBA, for sure, you would have some favorite moment or, you know, some story that you can share with us concerning
with
Kobe?
With Kobe? Yeah, I mean, I played the Lakers in the playoffs before several times. I think it was in Denver. And, first game, just watching and seeing him, you know, tip off, too. It was pretty cool. It's one of those surreal moments. You're like, that's Kobe Bryant. It's pretty cool. So I think, you know, just playing him in the playoffs and, you know, being on the same court as him during the playoffs is a surreal moment.
How was he as a person, you know, playing against him?
His killer mentality. That's why he was one of the best players of all time. You know, he never took a possession off. He played with his heart, and it showed. And that's why he's a huge inspiration to not only my generation, but generations before us.